the Suburban shopping mall where these wonderful little kids are waiting to see Santa Claus, who's coming to the shopping mall tonight by helicopter, and it's very exciting. I think we're beginning to see the helicopter. The helicopter's coming now. There it is. And that's the helicopter that Santa Claus is coming down to visit the kids in. And you can see these kids are very, very, very excited. And what is Christmas without Santa Claus coming? And of course, in today's modern world, Santa comes by helicopter. That's the way he comes. And it certainly is a beautiful night. We check with the weather service. It's really not the best weather for the helicopters, but you know, it's for the kids. And they don't want to disappoint these kids at all. So, here he comes. Santa's coming down now. And the excitement is building.
Here comes Santa Claus. Here comes Santa
Claus. The helicopter's starting to land. It's starting to land. What? There's something wrong. Something's going wrong with the helicopter. What? No! No, it's going to crash. The helicopter's going to crash. No! No, it's going to crash. No, get away, you kids. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. No. Santa Claus has been killed. It's the end of Christmas as we know it. Oh, no. This is terrible. This is terrible. Santa Claus is being burned up in the helicopter. This is terrible. This is really terrible.
Get the fire department over here. The fire department. Get the fire department. Get them quick.
They're pouring water on the helicopter, trying to douse the flames. Poor Santa. Santa.
Christmas is a time of giving. And there's an organization that gives us something every week. Actually, was it two or three times a week? It's the Suburban, or should we say the Suburban Journal. And of course, they give us a gift several times a week, their Suburban Journal. And by the way, we hope that you have sent in your voluntary subscription envelope. But that's what we're here to talk about. You know, after all the weeks and months and years of the Suburban Journal giving us something, me and Stinky here and Dave have decided that we'd like to give them something back in return. You got it with you, Stinky?
Yeah,
so let's go here. Come on. Hey, Suburban Journal! Yay!
Yeah.
Yeah. See how they like having junk in their lawn!
We'll give it back to you!
Yeah!
Christmas. Bah, humbug. I can remember when six kids knock on the door Christmas Eve, they sing a bunch of carols. So they open the door, they beat your brains out and tie you up in a cellar. Christmas. Humbug. In old days, used to snow a little, blizzards, icy winds, freeze your pants off. So you gotta get inside an air-cooled movie and pay a guy to drop tamper balls from the balcony to get the Christmas spirit. Christmas, you kidding or something? Humbug. Humbug, I say. Will you shut up?
Hi, it's Kathy. How you doing? It's nice to see you.
Pete, what are you doing here?
I'm looking for my Uncle Nunzio. You know, he's been in the country now for a few months, and, you know, he's just a dumb immigrant. He doesn't know the ways of the country too well, and he's kind of nervous, so he's been taking up drinking. He's been drinking a lot lately, and, well, you know, he has no money. So I got him a job here as a department store Santa Claus, and I'm kind of worried about him. I think he might be getting drunk on the job.
Going like this.
ain't nothing to be happy about. Hello, how are you doing today?
Yeah, I don't do so good.
I'm down to my last bottle of whiskey. I don't know what to do. I have no money. You know, anybody give me some money for some whiskey. You've been good this year.
Yep.
What's that gonna bring you? Bag of meth? Bag of meth.
I think it's a disgrace. What do I do?
Yeah. Could you do something for me for Christmas?
Get out of here. This is a disgrace. Come on,
it's Santa Claus. Wow, Santa Claus. It's amazing.
Hi, this is Santa. I can't go around this year because liability insurance on reindeers is too high.
But Santa,
and I won't be giving out gifts this year, but watch for my Christmas special from Las Vegas.
Well, first of all, let me say that there is no proof whatsoever that Jesus was born on December the 25th, that is his birthday.
Oh.
There's no mention of it in the Bible that he was born on December the 25th.
Is it?
There's no date of his birth. Nobody knows.
Yes, God bless you and Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas, Patreon Don. Wayne, my son. Born November 21st, 1993. Patricia Ann Wayne, my daughter, born July 17th, 1992. I would hope that you both have a wonderful day today. And I pray that God be with you and all of you who celebrate this white man's birthday that was born in Palestine in the harvest season. Because I know he couldn't have been possibly born at this time of year in your country, because guess what? You can't harvest no crops.
Dolomite is my name, and f***ing up motherfuckers is my game.
But y'all made him with blind hair and blue eyes, and he had no pigmentation at all like I have. But the Jesus that I worship, black Jesus, was born in Palestine and was a black man.
And tell him I want him out of here in 24 hours. And 23 of them are already gone.
And I'm of the tribe of Judah.
Breathing down your neck.
Girl, this motherfucker's got rhythm, haven't you?
But anyway, y'all have a very happy holiday and a prosperous and a merry new year. And guess what? May God be with you. May he bless you all. And may we see the black, no white, red, no yellow. There is any difference between us. We're all one. We bleed. We die. We're born.
He think he's bad and ain't got no class. I'm gonna wrap this shotgun up his motherfucking ass.
He gonna commit wholesale slaughter, murder, mayhem upon your own country. Yes, he will. He's already began. And guess what? You publicize with great dignity and pleasure the mayhem that blacks bring upon their blacks. Upon other blocks in your country.
Bad niggas, bad niggas.
Hi, this is PEP, welcoming you to a very special edition of Worldwide Magazine. As you know, the most wonderful, beautiful time of the year is Christmas time. And a question that a lot of people think about during this time of year is what Christmas means to me. Yes, those wonderful memories. Grandma, the Christmas tree, Santa Claus. Yes, by golly, this is the happiest time of year. And we want you to celebrate it right here as we rejoice during this gala Yuletide season. Right here, today, on Worldwide Magazine. Christmas mean to you?
Christmas means where the people get together and enjoy it and have a nice holiday and do nice things for other people. And most of all is the day of Christ was born, so we all should give thanks to him. That's about it.
Hi, this is Marty's brother Mark. Welcome to our Christmas show, Worldwide Magazine 1990. With a word of advice for you bi-state bus passengers seeking to swamp the malls. Smart people take the bi-state bus to wherever they're going for the holidays. And that's especially true if you want to take the bus to see your grandma, your relatives, grandpa, aunts, nieces, nephews, uncles. This is the way to go, the bi-state bus.
This is George, a bus driver. I'd like to tell you what Christmas means to me. Christmas means to me carrying little children and their mother and their grandfathers and their grandmothers and their fathers from place to place on the bus on Christmas Day.
Grandpa, I love my grandpa and I look for him to be with us every Christmas. And as far as I'm concerned, Pete, about Christmas in my younger years, it just used to be transistor radios and dog bones and torment. And I always was told that I'd get a paddle for Christmas instead of a transistor radio. And there was one time that I did get a bunch of paddles for Christmas for all the torment that I caused my mom and my dad. Well, it's not that way anymore. I mean, Christmas is more fun than usual now because riding bi-state buses is my hobby and I've got that to think about sometimes. There's just a world of possibilities, but while you're watching this show, keep that in mind and I will too as I get ready to ride the bi-state bus. One more time.
What Christmas means to me is I love carrying people around rather than being home with my family.
These look like some fabulous Yuletide decorations here, Mark. Who's responsible for all this?
Red. You know, Red Villa died the other day. So I devoted the bus colors in his honor.
Gee, that's very commemorative.
Yes, I thought of St. Louis's longest living alderman and chose to recognize him by the very nickname that most people called him would be Red Villa.
Thank you. Christmas tree. I'm a Christmas tree. Everybody hangs their ornaments on me. I'm a Christmas tree. I'm a Christmas tree. People throw me out on New Year's Eve.
What does Christmas mean to you?
What does it mean to me? What it means to me or to my children?
To whomever.
To whomever. Christmas means, well, religiously, the waiting of God to come, for he will come someday.
I should have called this a holiday season.
Right, right, a holiday season, right. And for my children, it's presents, family get-togethers, vacation, no school.
You spent a lot of money this year on presents?
No. No, not with six children.
Ooh.
No,
kind
of cut that.
As part of our celebration of this gala Yuletide season, we're with one of our favorite people in the whole world, Father Time. Well, Merry Christmas, Father Time.
Thank you. Merry Christmas to you and everybody who's looking in today.
And what are you doing to celebrate Christmas?
I spread around myself around and going to different places and play Christmas music. I have a tape of all Arkadin chimes and everybody enjoys listening too. And I normally celebrate from the week before Thanksgiving up to New Year's, all the way through playing this Christmas music.
Now, what does Christmas mean to you personally, Father Time?
It means so much to so many people because it's the Christ's birth. And regardless of religion, everybody wants to observe Christ's birth and keep it in the religion that they are in there also.
Well, you know, the thing that seems to be very special to me about Christmas is that it means something to everybody. It's the one holiday that means something to everybody throughout the world, even people that are non-Christians. They still observe the holidays. And Christmas means a lot to everybody in the world, even to people that have passed away. You know, wouldn't you say so, Father Time?
It's true, very true. I intend to go to the Calvary Cemetery myself, maybe tomorrow.
Well, we got something even better than that. There's a Hebrew cemetery across the street from where we're at, and we'd like to just kind of, in our own way, pay respect to the people in the cemetery and to the Christmas season itself by having you drive your truck around there and salute the people that have gone on to the other world and remind them that even they are part of the gala Yuletide season.
That's true, very true.
Father Time,
yes.
I wish that every day of the year, all 364 days of the year, could be Christmas. Yeah. I really do, don't you?
Right, sure.
I wish every day could be Christmas Day.
Enjoy every bit of it.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. That gala Yuletide season. It touches me. It pulls at the strings of my heart. That gala Yuletide season. Oh, yeah.
This is Father Time, World Wide Magazine, wishing all our Christian friends a Merry Christmas and our Hebrew friends a Happy Jew Year. Thank you.
Hey, hi, this is Dump Truck Dave Perry, coming to you people today to tell you what Christmas really means to me. You know, I've spent a few hours and a few days, actually a lot of days, in this jail cells around. The country has a lot of good jail cells, but none of them is as good as here in St. Louis. You know, it's a special feeling around Christmas time here. Usually a lot of the days we spend here, they get up in the morning and they serve you good stale donuts and cold coffee. Sometimes it doesn't hit real right on your stomach, but most of the time it really does. But you know, the thing we're here to talk to you about today is it's Christmas time. And around Christmas time, it really gets very special. The people in this area have a lot of a special glow, a certain aura about them, and it's really nice, really nice. On Christmas morning, we wake up around here, usually all the times I've been here, we wake up and they serve nice hot coffee and fresh donuts one day a year, and that's that special day like Christmas.
What's the matter, Stinky?
Pete, the sky's gonna fall.
What do you mean the sky's
gonna fall? The sky's gonna fall. Ivan Browning, he predicted the sky was gonna fall.
He predicted the earthquake.
Well, he was wrong about that. I heard the other day on TV, CNN, the sky is gonna fall.
You're saying that Ivan Browning has now been, he messed up with the earthquake. He's now predicting that the sky is gonna fall?
His calculations were wrong about the earthquake. What he meant was the sky was gonna fall, and I'm scared. I'm nervous about this.
Well, the sky's gonna fall at Christmas time?
Yes, it might even fall before.
Within 48 hours.
Yeah.
Right, well, they can't pin it down right to the minute. They have to put, it's like a window of opportunity there. 48 hours for the sky to fall.
I'm prepared.
Well, I don't think it's gonna happen. You gotta relax, Stinky.
No!
Just go and relax.
The sky's gonna fall.
Relax, Stinky. Relax. Stinky, the sky isn't gonna fall, Stinky.
Yes, it is.
The sky isn't falling. The sky looks fine. There's nothing in the sky. What's that guy? That's Stinky. He's crazy.
The sky is falling. Ivan Browning told us. The sky is falling. Ivan Browning told us this was gonna happen.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, once again, it's Big Daddy. It's Christmas 1990, even though it's about 60 degrees on two Sundays before Christmas. I'm down here on Cherokee Street with the Worldwide Magazine crew, and you know, I'm just reminiscing about Christmas past. You know, I remember when I was a youngster in South St. Louis, and it was pure and white in South St. Louis in those days and Christmas time, and it was a beautiful time. You know, we were so poor that our family couldn't afford to pay attention, and so what we do is my mom would give me a brand new Louisville Slugger every Christmas, and I'd just go out and hit the other kids in the head and take their bicycles and stuff, you know, just like nowadays. You know, things haven't changed much in South St. Louis in the last 20 or 30 years. And you know, you get lucky, you might get yourself a dollar. You can go over to the Globe Variety there and get yourself three cans of Blue Boy Vienna sausages and give to Pete Parisi for Christmas, because he likes those little weenie things, you know what I mean? So that's all Big Daddy's got to say. I can't remember too much about Christmas because I was usually drunk most of the time. So have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hi there, friends. You know who this is. That's Rides Elvis. I've come back from the dead to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year and a Happy Hanukkah, and whatever you're celebrating this year, I hope it's happy. You know, every year seems like the world gets to be a meaner place. People don't look out for each other like they used to in the old days. People don't even have bodyguards anymore like I used to. It's kind of sad, really. And for these folks to have to live here and on these streets and in these shelters like we're here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, it really is a mean season. So when you're all at home and you're with your family and friends and sipping your eggnog and watching your VCRs and porno movies, just having a good time eating them turkey legs and all that. Just remember that some people out here don't have it so good. And in honor of these folks, I'd like to sing a little song. Maybe cheer them up, maybe give them a little smile. Well, it's a blue Christmas without food. Yeah, it's gonna be a blue Christmas this year. A blue Christmas on a park bench, sleeping with a 40-ounce beer. It's terrible.
About Christmas, and what does it mean to you?
It means a time of giving and receiving a lot of presents.
That's right.
Given to everybody.
Here comes Marty. Hey, Marty. Come on in here, Marty.
Are you married?
No, I'm not.
Are you looking for a boyfriend?
No.
What, they ain't no good?
No, that's right.
You like me and Marty, don't you, Erica?
That was some real class there, baby. It was sweet.
What does Christmas mean to you, Cindy?
What does Christmas mean to me? Lots of love and lots of money.
Well, we got a lot of love, don't we, Marty, huh?
Now, see there? That's what really takes care of the cake. And ice cream and eat it all up.
Look at that, boy. Look at them legs. Look at them legs, boy. Look at them legs. Look at this shit. Tell me, Pete, does it stink now, huh?
Do I stink, Pete? No.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's all he talks about. Everything stinks. This woman does not stink. I know. Come on, get out of here, girls. Come
on, you want to be out there?
Come on.
I think she's great.
Yeah, I think she's great, too.
I think you guys are great.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, good.
And you always watch the Vince and Marty show, don't you?
I watch it every time.
That's right. That's right. See? Well, we'll see you, Pete. We'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Here we are with, what's your first name?
Sandra.
Sandra, how are you doing out here on Cherokee Street on a couple of Sundays before Christmas? Are you doing well?
As expected.
As well as expected. What does Christmas mean to you?
Yeah, what Christmas means to me?
Mm-hmm.
Good question.
What comes to your mind? How about presents?
Big ones.
Do you like getting big presents? Let me ask you, like, would you buy any of the presents and gifts that are for sale here on Cherokee Street?
Yeah.
Was there anything in this window here that you'd like?
That right there. Are you going to buy it for me?
Which one?
That one right there.
In the white?
Yeah.
Well, you know, you drive a hard bargain. You really do. That looks pretty good to me. That looks pretty good. So you like that?
Don't you?
Does that shirt? It looks fine to me.
Don't that look
good on you too, you know? I think it does. He's got, you know, I throw a log on the fire for that.
I hear you.
Are you wearing a bra?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, and once again, 1990 comes to a close, and I've been looking at the predictions for 1990 from the wonderful National Enquirer. I'd like to share a few of them. You know, none of these, and absolutely none of them came true. The first one here I really like is that Priscilla Presley is going to publish a sensational photo book about her life with the king, including shocking photos of a nude Elvis working around the house. That didn't happen, although I'd like to see that. And what here's, baseball will acquire its first female player after she becomes a sensation playing for a Japanese team. That hasn't happened. And here's my personal favorite. Jackie Onassis will wed rock star Bon Jovi, John Bon Jovi. Hey, Stinky, what? What?
What's going on? What are you reading there? What are you reading there?
I'm reading the predictions for 1990.
Did they predict that the sky was going to be falling?
They did say that there's going to be a meteorite to blitz the White House.
The sky is falling. That's what I keep telling everybody. They won't pay attention.
That's not happening.
Ivan Browning has changed his prediction. The sky's falling. Big Daddy, you got to get an umbrella. Protect yourself.
I'll do my best, even. I don't think it's going to happen. You know,
that
could be one of those predictions just like this. You know, I don't know. Sniggy's kind of lost it, I think, there.
Well, we want to ask you, what does Christmas mean to you?
Well, Christmas to me, it's a very, very personal holiday. I get together with my kin. We drink heavily. And we decorate the house. We decorate things. I put a big bow on my pickup truck on the grill.
Put a big bow on your pickup truck?
Yeah, it's Christmas decoration. And what else do? We drink.
You already said that.
Well, we do that many times. Then we have contests to see who could drink the most and who can drink the most before they throw up. And have boiled ham sandwiches.
Sounds real picturesque.
Am I on television?
No, you're not on television.
Oh, I'm pretty good.
What are you doing?
Oh, just taking a walk.
What does Christmas mean to you?
Oh, it means seeing the people I care about. Presents and things like that.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
What? You want to pull on this jug?
No, thanks. I'm going to be on my way.
Never touch this stuff.
Ever since I was a young kid, growing up on the 2600 block of Utah, the biggest thrill every Christmas was to come up to the Globe Variety Store and get to sit on Santa Claus's lap. Every year, me and my sisters and my brother would kick and scream until we were brought up here to visit Santa.
Well, we're at the Globe Variety Store here on Cherokee Street, and we're with Santa Claus. How are you doing, Santa?
Fine. How are you today, Pete?
Okay, now listen, let me ask you, Santa. When is the point that kids get too old to sit on Santa's lap?
Oh, you're never too old to sit on Santa Claus's lap, Pete.
Hold on a second. Yoo-hoo! Yoo-hoo! We got somebody here that's going to want... It's his turn now. Come over here. He wants to sit on your lap. Okay, sit on his lap.
Yeah, where do you want me to sit at?
Right here, big guy.
Why don't you sit on my lap?
No, you sit on my lap.
Come on, Dave, me and you both. How about the dump truck, too? Come on, Dave. You know what we want for Christmas?
What do you want for Christmas,
Pete
Big Daddy?
Pete Parisi's death. That's what we want. We want Pete to die for Christmas. That's what we're looking for.
Okay, we'll see what we can do about it.
Say Merry
that.
Christmas. Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas. Thanks, Santa. You're a real sport, no kidding.
I hope you got some insurance for them legs, buddy.
No problem.
This earthquake thing has got me. The sky's been falling and everything else. I want to show you what happened. Ivan Browning, you know, y'all predict this earthquake. Well, this is what's going to happen. You know, like, kids are going to be going to school and they're all going to be crowding their school buses. And, like, all of a sudden they're going to crash and everything. And then, like, kids will be falling out like this, you know. And then another truck will come over them. He won't know it and they'll back up over him and they'll be squashed. And then the kids will be on fire. Because this one will come in and it'll start on fire and everything. And then this guy will come over here. And he'll land up on top of them. It'll be miserable. All the kids will be dead. And it'll be because they wouldn't listen to Ivan Browning and Stinky when they tell them the sky is falling and earthquake's coming. Nobody will listen to us. But that's what's going to happen. That's it right there. Predict.
How are you today?
I'm pretty good, Santa-san.
You want to tell me what you want for Christmas?
Oh,
I would like a dog smoker.
A dog smoker?
Uh-huh, to smoke the dogs for better taste. And I wish that more people turn the dogs loose on the streets.
What, do you relate it to Alf or something?
No. I'm just a hungry guy.
How are you doing? Y'all look so cute. Can we ask you what you're doing?
Yes, we celebrate December 12th, the Lady of Guadalupe.
Our Lady of Guadalupe. Is this
it's
a Mexican celebration? And what do you do on the Feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe?
We go to church. And
is this the way you dress all the time?
No, only this day. Yeah. It's a special day.
Well, these costumes are so colorful. Who makes these?
I made it, my mother.
You made these?
Yes.
Look at these. Get up here. Show your dress off. This is amazing. And what did you do? Did you guys just get back from Mass?
Yes.
And did you get anything to eat afterwards, or did you get any kind of reward for dressing up so pretty?
No, we hear people dancing, and Mexican dancing and all kinds of dancing.
Hey, Gail, how you doing, baby?
Hi. Well, I'm just out here shopping for Christmas, of course. Big Daddy, could you lend me a little money so I could do some Christmas shopping?
Yeah, sure. What do you need? A couple dollars?
Dollar? This is Cherokee Street, you know.
That's right, the dollar. They got a $1.98 store right up the street. Hey, wait a minute, watch it. Hey, Dave.
Oh!
Oh, no. Oh, it's a woman, Dave. She's so gorgeous. I got to have you for Christmas.
Oh, no. Big Daddy,
give me
Heather. Big Daddy, help me.
I'd like to help you, but I just can't.
Oh,
watch it. I'd like to help you, but I just can't.
Hi, once again it's time for a special edition of One Man's Opinion. Well, this is our special Christmas time edition of One Man's Opinion. There's a few things I'd like to discuss with you real briefly. For one thing, people are always criticizing Christmas, saying that it's too commercialized. You've heard that for many years. I've heard it since I was a kid. And this is a really stupid misconception. So you think about it. If it wasn't for merchants and for businesses, there wouldn't be a Christmas. Most of the Christmas music you hear is on TV commercials. Most of the Christmas decorations you see are in stores. So, if it wasn't for the commercialism of Christmas, there wouldn't be a Christmas. So don't criticize Christmas for being too commercial. Thank God that it is. After all, it is the gala Yuletide season. And speaking of this very, very, very religious season, I think it's time to talk a little bit about religion. People ask me what I think of God. And all I can say is three things. He's a fun guy, he has a great sense of humor, and he's a great practical jokester. You know, people say that God is dead. He's not dead. He's just sleeping. And, you know, we're talking about homeless people. You always talk a lot about homeless people around Christmas time. And all these people feel so good. They give these homeless people a free turkey dinner and a pat on the back and a few little Christmas carols at Christmas and everything's okay. What about the other 364 days of the year? Well, turkey ain't gonna last that long. My favorite Christmas show on TV that I've ever seen was a special Christmas episode of Dragnet. And this episode was about the Christ child being stolen out of a manger in Los Angeles. And it was in a poor neighborhood, and they spent the whole episode looking for the missing Christ child that belonged in the manger. And they finally found it. Somebody took it, and they got it back. And Jack Webb and the priest of the parish are standing over the manger watching the Christ child restored to the manger. And the priest turned to Jack Webb and said, "Wouldn't it be wonderful, Sergeant, if there was no more crime and bad things in the world?" And Jack Webb looked right at the camera and said, No, I don't think so. We'd both be out of jobs. I just think that kind of sums up my feelings about the Christmas season. You always hear that religious song. I mean, we're talking a lot about religion because it's Christmas. Bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. Did you ever wonder what a sheave was? And that wraps up this special Yuletide edition of One Man's Opinion. Take a picture of the Christmas tree.
What's Christmas mean to you? Just come up with something.
What does Christmas mean to me?
Quick, before this other guy gets
what
here.
What has people been saying? Christmas means joy and giving.
Wild parties,
and
drinking,
friendship,
debauchery.
And new clothes.
You still have your botch?
Huh?
You still have your botch?
My botch?
Botch. Haven't you ever heard of when someone has their botch removed, they've been debauched?
Oh, no, I still have my botch. I sure hope.
You know anything about stamp collecting?
Do I know anything about stamp? No.
Stamp collecting. What's your position on Fallacia? Stamp collecting.
Yeah.
Stamp collecting.
Yeah, stamp collecting.
Hurry up, ladies and gentlemen. We're here at the St. Louis Center. You must hurry up and do your Christmas shopping right away. There are only 20 days left till Christmas. Actually, about 15 days left till Christmas. At the beautiful St. Louis Center, we are here looking and taking in all of the sights, all of the sounds of Christmas at the center. It is urgent that you get to the stores and spend your money. Put that money down on the table. Buy any trinket, anything that you can think of. You stupid humans, don't you know what Christmas is all about? It's about buying and selling and buying, getting, receiving. Here we are at the beautiful Ann Taylor Clothing Shop. Everything priced about 200% more than it costs. It's a wonderful place. Look at these beautifully wrapped packages. These lights, everything. It is amazing what money is spent here at the St. Louis Center to enhance your buying pleasure. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, you must hurry and buy. Christmas is only 14 days away. You only have 14 days to spend your life savings on Christmas. Buy presents for people you don't even like. That's what Christmas is all about. This is a wonderful time of the season. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, you only have 14 days left of Christmas. You must hurry down here to the center. Spend all of your life savings. You must spend it. We have the Baker shoes, the 579, the Wild Pair. Anything that you could want is right here at the center. Peck and Peck, 16 plus, Lady Foot Locker, Camelot Music. What else could you want? Here's Michael's Cookies and Yogurt and Fannie Mae Candies. This is a plethora of shopping pleasure down here at the St. Louis Center. Everyone is excited to be down here, and especially us.
You call that a Christmas tree? It's just a stub.
That's a beautiful Christmas tree. That's a rare oriental dwarf tree.
I hope it's nobody important. I don't want to see that ugly tree.
Will you shut up about that tree?
It's ugly.
It's a beautiful tree.
Hey, it's a Nunzio. Merry Christmas,
everyone. Don Mike.
Oh, yeah. Don't do that, man.
Merry Christmas. What do you think this is, Sicily? Come on in. Sit down.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Sit right over there, Uncle Nunzio.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd drop by on my good friends, spread the Christmas cheer. Hey, Ruth, I got something for you.
That's nice of you.
This handkerchief. Could you clean it out? I've got a cold.
Ah! Don't throw your dirty snot rag on me, you greasy goomba.
My favorite thing of the Christmas holiday is the food and the cooking. Oh, there's nothing like the wonderful food and the smells. Like Ruth, I could smell your cooking all the way out on the sidewalk.
Or if you're hungry, we got plenty of food in there. I'll fix you something.
Ooh, I'm real hungry. You fixing me something to eat? Mingy, I'm so hungry. I think I'll take a sample of this before they come back out. I wonder what it is. Eh? Eh? Holy Mary! Mother of God! It is the head of an animal! Mingy, these people are like animals! Cannibals! Oh my God!
Hey, Uncle Nunzio, come on. Ruth's got the food ready. Let's go eat.
No. I can't eat another bite.
What do you mean?
I had a bowl of soup about 10 hours ago. No, I cannot eat anything. No, I'm full, completely full. I cannot eat nothing.
Well, all right.
I gotta go. I gotta go right now. I got to see a movie. I gotta see The Godfather 3, yeah.
Oh, gonna see your countrymen, huh?
Yeah, that's what I gotta do. I gotta go. I cannot eat. No.
Well, Mike, in spite of everything, I am starting to get in the Christmas spirit. Even with that ugly tree you brought home. That was the ugliest tree I ever saw.
You wouldn't talk about my Christmas tree.
Well, I guess it'll just have to do. And really, after everything, I really do wish everybody a very Merry Christmas.
Ruth, baby, you're the greatest.
There's an earthquake coming. I'm reporting to you from the Double Helix Science Center, then News Bureau, at the desk of 625 North Euclid. Let me tell you, we just got a report that an earthquake hit South St. Louis. I know that's not too important to most of you people, and it's not important to the people in South St. Louis. But anyway, we're telling you, find shelter, quickly, find shelter. Hurry up. What else do we, that's what we want you to do. Get under a table. Let me drink some coffee here. Just a second, I'm getting thirsty. Maxwell House, I love it.
You made me love you. You didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You know you made me love you. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. You really did.
And stay tuned to hear for all the profanity you ever want to hear and more about the earthquake in South St. Louis.
Okay, we're talking to some real nice people, some shoppers here at the St. Louis Center, and we're asking everybody today what Christmas means to you. Could you tell us?
Christmas means to me? About this time of Christmas, my brother bring more dope in so we make more money.
All right, that's good. That's the...
How y'all doing to my sister? See, Christmas means sharing a wonderful time with me and my girlfriend.
I feel the same way.
Being enjoying each other's company and receiving a gift from each other.
Yeah, I feel the same way.
So basically, Christmas to these people means sex and dope.
Hurry, you gotta get out of here. You gotta get out of here. The sky is falling. The sky is falling.
As 1990 rolls to a close, what a glorious year it was. And of course, this is our last show of 1990, so we'd like to take a minute out as we approach the end of this show and give you a little collage of some of those wonderful moments of that wonderful year, 1990, as Worldwide Magazine presents our year in review.
Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows my sorrow.
Work for the white man. The white man.
Oh my gosh!
This is my own.
If you only knew how.
The trouble I've seen. Glory, hallelujah. Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows.
So if it was a good alien, we would be against the abortion.
Nobody.
And you, old man, wake up before it's too late.
Glory, hallelujah. Sometimes I'm up, sometimes I'm down. Oh, yes, Lord. Sometimes I'm almost to the ground. Oh, yes, Lord.
For 4.5 years, this Southside cabbie has produced a weekly one-hour comedy program called Worldwide Magazine, shown on both city and county cable TV to an ever-growing audience. But last week, Parisi was canceled.
Every day to you I pray. Oh, yes, Lord, for you to drive my sins away. Oh, yes.
So the homeless problem is growing year by year. It's not shrinking.
Oh, it's definitely growing year by year. The fact of the matter is, now that Ben Schimmel's in the shelter business and has so many shelters that he prides himself on, tells us that. But the fact is that animals need shelters, people need homes. If he'd stop tearing down their homes, he wouldn't have to put so many women and children in shelters.
Nobody knows the trouble.
We want to ask you a question, okay?
No, sorry.
Sorry.
You can't do that, okay?
Oh, sorry?
No picture.
What's Worldwide Mag and what's this sex day?
I'm gonna stick this up crazy. Don't bother my dog one more time.
Okay, I'm sorry. I won't.
And that'll go up your eye that way.
Ah, what a wonderful year it was. 1990, as it goes into the annals of history. 1990, yes, those were the golden moments. And believe it or not, the sad thing is that sometime in the future, we'll be referring to 1990 as the good old days. But as we approach the end of the year, and as, of course, we're in the gala Yuletide season right now, I'd like to give you this heartfelt wish from the bottom of my heart to all of you out there in TV land. And I mean this very sincerely. I hope that all of you out there have as good a year in 1991 as I did in 1990.
Jimmy.
Come here. Turn around. I want to know why you're mad at me. I'm your main man.
Yeah, you ain't my goddamn mother. Bring you.
What did he do?
Stupid son of a bitch. You ran my fucking out of here because you hate her. You don't like her, but and then you call her a fuck. of it. Well, you mother... You, I'm gonna get the goddamn labor board in your ass.
I wanna know one thing. They true.
Get the fuck out of my goddamn face,
they
you mother.
They true rider.
Get out of my face.
They true rider.
Tell me, get the fuck out of my face.
They true out of the drug rehabilitation because she had drugs.
You fuck. What? Bald headed, gray headed bitch.
Well, you told me that you had a hard time
now,
having her with the blue jeans on. You wanted her to get a dress so you
never
can pull
mind
it off
all that.
Fast.
You
so
seen I was getting put 7 days a week. You seen I was getting coming to see me 2 days a week, and you couldn't stand that because you ain't getting nothing. And then you had to for me.
Were you jealous, Gus?
Oh, she's beautiful. She weighs 485 pounds. A tow truck brought her here.
Come on, don't bend the story.
I ain't bending the story. She broke the damn truck.
Now, I've met her before, and she seemed quite nice to me. She seemed very nice.
Hey, Jimmy, to change the subject, could you tell us what Christmas means to you?
If I had my girlfriend back here with me, that would be Christmas.
Well, what does Christmas mean to you? How did you spend Christmas when you were a little boy?
I don't know. I wish the I was out of this world sometime and never came back. I mean that. My girlfriend's there, not with me right now, and he...
You were supposed to have sex with her today, right? Give me $3 and
I'll... I hate Italians and Greeks.
You hate Italians and Greeks? Why?
You know, a woman will do three things to you. She'll put you in a penitentiary, she'll put you in a cemetery, and she'll put you in a crazy house.
Now look at what you got. You ain't got nothing, and I still got a head of hair.
What Christmas mean to you?
What Christmas mean to me? I look here, I want some bite and some tar.
Pete, we have a serious situation here. Jimmy's girlfriend is missing. Now, you know, this time of year is the one time of year when people just don't want to be alone and by themselves. So what we want to do here is have Jimmy, in his own words, make an appeal to Linda to come home, to come in from the cold, to come to Jimmy's house, to contact him here or contact him at home. The important thing is to get in contact with him somewhere because he's worried and wants her to come back. Jimmy, go ahead.
I forgot what I'm supposed to say.
Linda,
come back to me, wherever you are. Come back, contact me, do something. Come back, I'm worried sick out of my head. You're causing me to get back on the booze again.
Go ahead, keep going. We don't want that. Tell her how much you love her.
I love you too much. On top of that, I give you a goddamn engagement ring.
Merry Christmas from Gus's Clothes Fashion.
Merry Christmas, everybody, from Detective Sergeant Frank Serpico, NYPD, and to Gus's Fashions as well. And to my lady friend, Linda Wade, and her father, Vincent Wade, well. Come home, Linda, wherever the hell you're at, show your goddamn country ass.
I want to wish all my customers a Merry Christmas from Gus's Fashions. And Daryl Strawberry's going to be here with my cousin Tom Lasorda and Charlie Gito.
You talked enough, Gus. We're leaving.
Oh, God.
The sky is falling! Everybody! The sky is falling! Look out!
amazing, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. The greatest.
It's just the most wonderful time of the year. It's just filled with beautiful people. There's a special glow in the air. And it's just great just to be alive. Wouldn't you say so, Vince?
Oh, it's great, Pete. I tell you, all these beautiful women down here in South St. Louis. Look at them all in their nice, beautiful clothes for Christmas. Oh, man, it's beautiful down here.
What do you think, Marty?
Yeah, I just heard Pete Parisi burn up a Christmas tree. He said it too close to the fireplace and his house burnt down.
Okay, on that note, I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas from Worldwide Magazine. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry
We wish you a Merry Christmas!